Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today I will be analyzing the upcoming IPO of Frontier Group Holdings, which is basically the airline that is expected to go public on March 31st, 2021 in the NASDAQ under the ticker symbol ULCC. As always, my aim with this video will be to give a bit of a summary of the main topics that I could see in the SEC filing, to give us a general overview on the company, and to help us determine whether this could potentially present us with a good opportunity of investment or not. Before we dive into the content, let me quickly give you a short overview of the topics that I will be covering in today's video. So first of all, I will be giving a general introduction to Frontier, and also we will look at some general metrics of the company. Then we will look into the financials, and we will compare this with two other ultra low-cost airlines, which are Spirit and Allegiant. And we will see how this compare. Afterwards, we will check its IPO price and valuation, that of Frontier. And again, we will compare it with the two competitors to see if we would be getting a good deal investing in its IPO or not. And finally, as always, I will be giving my personal opinion on the stock and my future plans with it. With that said though, and after I do the classic disclaimer saying that I'm no financial advisor and that I'm just doing this video for entertainment purposes, and also after I remind you that if you enjoyed the video, it would be super awesome if you could give it a like, let's go for it. Frontier, as you might already know and be familiar with, is an ultra low-cost airline that operates mostly domestic flights within the United States, although also some international, only to locations with high demand and that are profitable for them. In total, they operate a network of 110 airports, and the top 5 cities for them at the end of last year were Denver, with 20% of departures, followed by Orlando, Las Vegas, Philadelphia, and Phoenix. When looking at the market share of domestic flights within the US of Frontier with respect to its competitors, we see that they only represent a 3.3% of the total market, and within ultra-low-cost carriers, only Spirit Airlines has more market share. They have a highly simplified fleet of airplanes, which is kind of normal in low-cost airlines as they try to keep the costs as low as possible, and of course this helps, composed of a total of 104 planes, Airbus, A319, A320, and A321. The fleet of planes is actually one of the most modern ones, and the average age of the whole fleet is only of 4 years, and they even have several orders during the upcoming years to acquire more new ones. As you can see in the image in the screen, they have already agreed to purchase a total of 156 aircrafts, most of which until 2025, although 66 are after that. And one of the reasons they do this is because newer planes are more efficient and they use less fuel. And actually, they estimate that the next generation of A320 that they will have with a new engine, they will provide 15% fuel efficiency versus previous generations. Actually, this strategy that they followed has positioned them as the US greenest airline, which is basically understood as the one with highest fuel efficiency. When comparing it with other big names, we see that all of the ones in the screen burn more fuel than Frontier. But leaving aside the planes they buy, which they want them to be as efficient as possible, they have also removed unnecessary weight of the planes they operate by removing Wi-Fi and in-flight entertainment, the tray tables are also lighter, and the seats are ultra lightweight. All of these strategies have led them to having very low cost per available seat mile. As you can see in the graph in the screen comparing different carriers, Frontier, together with the other ultra low cost airlines, have the lowest cost and with certain margin over the others. In 2019, Frontier was actually the one with the cheapest cost, and basically these low costs are what allow them to offer flights at very low prices. We mentioned the fuel efficiency, but other aspects that also contribute to them having such low cost is that they outsource several services, including customer service, lost bag services, ground handling, and catering, which of course from a cost perspective is much more savvy, but then it usually also leads to worse customer experience. Finally, to end with another relevant aspect in the low-cost structure that we have been mentioning so far, they sold 71, 73, and 76% of the tickets respectively during the years 2018, 19, and 20 directly to consumers through either their website or the mobile app, which are the cheapest distribution channels. This number is not only very high, but also we see a positive trend as this is increasing year over year, and overall I just see it as something very positive. Now going into the financials and the performance, as with the other airlines out there, this has not been very good lately. Looking first at revenues, they've decreased 50% year over year, although during the previous years this had been following a consistent uptrend and increasing in more than 10% every single year. Then looking at the bottom line, they reported significant losses this past year of $225 million, although they were a profitable company before, and in the previous years they had been consistently reporting profits. Finally, the balance sheet certainly does not look nice, and they have a lot of debt. In fact, its debt ratio is of 91.28%, which is very high, as the debts are almost more than the total value of its assets. Nevertheless, it is not worse than the balance sheet of American Airlines that has more than 100% debt ratio, which means that they have more debt than assets, and essentially, if now they wanted to pay out all the debt that they have, even if they were to sell all of its assets, they would still not have enough money to pay all of it, which is of course not good. But going back to Frontier, they are still at a not so good position with so much debt. Of course, they are backed like all the other airlines out there in the US, but still, as I said, it's not a healthy position to be in. Now that we have checked the financials of Frontier, it is time to compare them with the two other competitors within the space of ultra low cost fares, which are Spirit Airlines and Allegiant. First, focusing on revenues, we see that the drop has been in line with that of its competitors, although Allegiant has been the one with less decrease year over year. Also, it is the smallest one in size, which also makes it a bit easier as they did not have so many planes to maintain while they were not able to fly them. And then in net income, all of them reported losses this past year, but more interesting than just looking at the numbers are the margins of each one of them. When comparing this, we see that Allegiant is the one with higher net income margins, while Spirit is the worst one. And then the final point of comparison with the financials is the debt ratio in the balance sheet, and Frontier is the one with more debt respective to the assets by a considerable difference, which is not good. After this short comparison of the financials, we should move into the IPO price and valuation of Frontier. On it, based on the information that we currently have available at the moment of recording this video, it should start trading at a price range between $19 and $21 per share. And taking the middle point of that, the number of outstanding shares projected after the public offering and the sales of this past year, we have that it should start trading at a price-to-sales ratio of 3.44. And if we compare this with its competitors, Spirit and Allegiant, Spirit is currently trading at 2x sales and Allegiant at 4.15. However, what I think that is also interesting to see is what would be the current price to sales ratio if we were to take the sales of the year 2019, so the revenues that they made before the pandemic, which is what hopefully we could expect them to make going out of the current situation, which 2021 will not happen because we are still with lots of lockdowns and so on, but maybe 2022 could be a potential future scenario for that. And if we were to do the price to sales ratio, as I have just mentioned now, we find that Frontier would be trading at 1.72x, Spirit at 0.92, and Allegiant at 2.23. Based on all of these and what we have been commenting throughout the whole video, I personally will not be investing in the IPO of Frontier. And it's not that I think that it's super overvalued or anything, I think that it's trading in line with what the other airlines are trading at the moment. But I do think that in general the market is a bit overvalued, especially with airlines and recovery stocks, as they are already at pre-pandemic levels. For instance, Spirit is already at pre-pandemic levels, and Allegiant is at all-time highs, and we are not even yet out of this pandemic. So for me, the risk reward on investing in Frontier, especially in a very competitive industry like the airlines market, and also considering that it has a lot of debt, as we saw before, I basically see better plays out there when it comes to risk reward. I'm not sure if I already mentioned this, but actually, and for what I just said, probably you guessed it, which is that I would not at the current prices invest in any airline stock myself. I do have some positions, but I bought them long time ago. I'm more than like 50% up. But if I wanted to really invest in the airline industry at the moment, for me, a better risk reward play could be Boeing. That yes, it has already recovered a lot of what it lost, but I think that it still has upside potential. And if what you believe in is the airline industry, it's a much safer play, as there is only another major competitor, which is Airbus, and I think that there is room for both of these to grow. Anyways, this was the end of my analysis. Remember that these are just my thoughts, my personal opinions, and the research that I have done myself on the company, but that you should always do your own due diligence before investing in this or any stock. Nevertheless, I'm curious to know, what are your thoughts on Frontier? Will you be investing in its IPO? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.